Pete Donaldson's still backstage at V Festival with Huey and Fast from the Fun Loving Criminals in their dressing room.
Yeah, rare.
You had to pass through that whole like Russian security check where we like total recalled you. And
yeah, they got gloves out and everything. It was crazy. It was a bit much, to be honest.
I'm sorry, we just can't afford to have people in here with, you know,
willy nilly. You've seen the riots already in London.
Yeah, and like we don't want one here.
No,
you know?
Exactly.
And Plan B's right across the way, and he's really volatile.
I reckon he could take a few people down. He could kick in a shop window, I reckon.
Yeah, no, he did. He got a mad TV. Look at his dressing room.
Are you guys at home at festivals, or do you prefer something a little bit more intimate?
Well, we like it all.
Yeah, we like it all. I mean, if we play live, I said it today, we play for the people instead of to the people. And I think it's important to have that mantra, really, because you could play a festival or a club or, you know, anywhere, but you're playing for the people, not to them.
Yeah.
So, like, they had a good time today because we did. We came with good vibes and love and all that, and it was nice. And it's good to open up a festival, too.
Yeah.
Because now they got to better us. Whoever comes on after us got to do better.
Yeah.
And then
you guys can start drinking, can't you? You guys can party.
And we did pretty damn good today.
So. They gave us Patron tequila, which is just huge. Again, Patron, because that way we get the free Patron.
Can I get on this? Patron.
Patron, the best silver.
You're going to cut this out.
We had Sunshine, though, and then we're like the only band that's going to have Sunshine today. So.
I know, yeah, you sort of stole it, didn't you?
No, because it was one of those things.
Steal my Sunshine.
It was made to be, because we haven't played V Festival in a long, long time.
Yeah.
And it's one of those festivals that's very commercial and very, you know, chart-based. And I don't think we've been on the chart next to me being at the hospital and having a hospital chart for a long time.
Yeah.
So for people to enjoy the music and enjoy the vibe, enjoy the show, and get ready for the rest of the stuff, I thought was really cool.
Well, I caught a little bit of it. It was kind of a greatest hit set. There was a couple of new ones shoved in there as well.
Half an hour. So it was kind of like we wanted to start off nice and, you know, kind of ease people into their weekend. Mm. And then by the end, we were kicking ass like it was like tin cans.
It's a great advert for your live album you're sort of putting out now. That's out now, isn't it?
We just put it out, 3-CD live record, yeah.
It's quite an interesting way to do it as well. You did like a pledge system. People who wanted to hear it bought, sort of pre-ordered it effectively. Yeah. And that's surely the future of record releasing.
I think so, because if people like a band, they'll go to the band's website and try to see what the band is up to, not what the band's record company's up to,
because
that's completely different. So if you like a band, go to their website, and I bet you 9 times out of 10 you'll find stuff there that's more interesting that you'd get through the big filtered, you know, music machine.
Well, I mean, you guys released an album last year, wasn't it? And it must be good to write records again, because you're tied down to a bit of a contract that meant that you couldn't release any more music, and it must feel good.
It's always good to make a record, release a record, and then tour a record. I mean, that's the whole process, what we've grown to love in 15 years of doing this, you know?
But the paradigm shifted, though, in a lot of ways, because you make a record, and then that record goes in the, you know, people buy records. Anybody over 11 years old doesn't buy a record anymore.
Yeah, yeah.
They can listen to it on Spotify, on YouTube, whatever. So it's when people come to see you play live that they really appreciate what's going on. That's why we put the live record out, because we never actually released any of our live stuff, and we're very different live than we are on record.
Yeah.
And that was one thing we wanted to get across.
Well, it's a bit of a show, isn't it? You are entertainers first and foremost, I think it's fair to say, isn't it?
Thank you. We try to be. Yeah,
that's when the band started.
One of my first live experiences was you guys, I think, I don't think it was Glasgow, it might have been Reading, actually, you doing a whole, you do like a scene from Scarface and stuff.
Yeah, Hughes Acting School.
Yeah, that was
wicked.
Because
there were a lot of kids there that were actors that didn't really know a lot. People like Orlando Bloom and Russell Crowe.
Orlando whom?
And then, you know, later on they became Oscar award winning actors and things because of our instruction.
Well, I think that's probably
won
right.
No Oscar.
It's like, you gotta look at it this way, man. We like three dudes, like regular guys, and you put us in front of like 50,000 people, we're gonna have some fun with it. You can't take yourself too seriously or you'll be Coldplay.
Yeah.
So I mean, not to diss them, but to say
feel free.
No,
knock yourself out.
That's them. We're the Fun Loving Criminals, we're from New York. We wanna play music for the people. And it's actually written about the people, so it should be, you know, relative.
Yeah. At the moment, you're kind of doing a bit of radio as well, aren't you? You must be enjoying that as well.
Yeah. It's fun because I get to play all the music I like that made Fun Loving Criminals, you know, all the different...
Because you're all music fans, aren't you? You're all very much sort of like... from like the soul classics to, and you can hear the influences right through, and you always have sort of out and said that.
Frank and Fast have this thing called Radio Riddlers, like a reggae based project, and they do a lot of, you did Marvin Reggae, which I named, by the way. Remember that?
Yeah, you did, yeah.
I named that. But he did, like, you know, all the Marvin Gaye vocals, reggae music that he produced underneath it.
And it's lovely, really, strong bass lines as well.
Yeah, and also
God, always.
You did, you did Purple Reggae,
with Prince's Purple Rain.
That's pretty good.
But Ollie Campbell singing on it.
And we remixed Bruno, even though Bruno don't know we remixed him.
Go and tell him.
We've already handed out loads of CDs. So. As long as he don't come after us.
Good stuff. What's next for the Fun Loving Criminals?
I think we're probably going to do a little bit of playing and a little bit of soul searching and a little bit of living, because a lot of us recently, Fast and ourselves, have just become recently fathers.
Yeah.
So
that must have knocked you guys for six, being a touring band.
Yeah, you know, and it's one of those things that I think we want to kind of, like, you know, invest in our family a little bit and also have something to write about.
Yeah.
Because we've been doing it for so long, there hasn't been a really a break for us to actually, you know, live a bit of a life.
Yeah. So you're not going to do a David Bowie and just call it a day.
Well, no, if someone wants to offer us $42 million for our futures, yeah, that's cool. I'll do that. Yeah,
get back next week for that.
I'll do that. Yeah, yeah, but
I'll sell the kids. It's fine.
Ain't nobody knocking on the door for that shit. No, but no, we're having fun doing it. It's like, you know, playing out here, like, you know, half the people knew us, half the people didn't. But by the end of the show, everybody has a smile on their face. That's what we're about.
Exactly. Huey, Fast, Fun Loving Criminals, back in the dressing room. Thank you very much.
Thank you.